this. You want to do this or should we proceed to the next one? You want to do this? Little different. It is like this only in the question also. Draw your own diagram. You can draw the circles, right? Not as good as mine. Bio, take up. Botany and zoology, both. You came on your own or your parents sent you?
Both.
Both ways?
Yeah.
So, it concludes your parent has. Done?
Yes, sir.
For case A, I'll write down the answer. This is the answer, try getting it. Anybody got this?
Yes.
Got it?
Yes.
Okay, please help others. I'll just come. Okay, Param, please. Please explain all of us.
This one?
Chup jao.
It's at a distance of x minus r from the radius of the small sphere.
Okay, so?
So
see, from if it is at a distance r from here, sorry, at x from here, from center it will be?
X minus R.
X minus R, all of you agree this? From here, this distance is X. From this distance is R. So from center it is X minus R. Okay? And we have already derived the gravitational force is how much?
G.
If that is the case, G mm dash divided by
R
cube into
X minus R.
Into X minus R. Into the solid and it is inside the shell.
Shell
won't affect anything. Got it? We are using the direct expression which we have derived earlier. The two questions back, we are continuously using it. The previous question as well as this one also. And if it is here, then x is here.
The shell does nothing again.
Shell again does nothing, but it is outside the solid sphere, which will be like a point object. So it will be G mm dash divided by
x minus r
whole square. Okay, you know, a simple question. Yeah, I thought it now 6 sentences are written, so I got after. X greater than 2r, then what will happen? Both will be a point mass. This point mass will be located at the center, its own center. The shell's point mass is located here. Add the two forces. All of you clear? Clear, right? Okay.
Wait, so sir, in the C part, you assume that the solid sphere is a point mass at its center and the sphere is
on centers.
But
this is P2, this is P1.
So you need to know where P1 is to know where P2 is.
I can't read the
P1
on the side.
The uniform metal sphere of radius A and
P is at a distance of A from
the
surface. Kya funny hai?
It wasn't funny, Sadhguru just said the same thing again. He's like, P is inside the circle.
Funny hai?
Not funny hai, I wasn't laughing.
Has to raja tu, hasrat nahi
hai? I know.
A uniform metal sphere of radius A and mass M is surrounded by thin uniform spherical shell of equal mass M and radius 4A. Okay, the center of the shell falls on the surface of the inner sphere. This is the center. Find the gravitational field at point P1 and P2 shown in the figure. So from P1 to this is A. and this is also A from here to here. Are you getting it? And everything lie along this line. Not of it.
At G1 is GM by 16. There it is. G1 GM by 900.
61.
B2.
How much?
61 GM by 900.
Anybody else got the answer?
On the first.
तो उसके बगल में बैठा है ना इसलिए आगे
तेरा. Me. I'm not before you.
Oh, okay. He copied you.
I wrote the expression before you. I
calculated.
I did. Okay, so half of work you did, half of work you
did. No, sir, we did separately.
Separately. Done?
Yeah.
Those are simple, simple questions. These are all JEE Mains level. So, the at point P1, how will you find it?
Only for
this one, which is from center, it is at a distance of how much?
4A.
This is 4A. This one can't apply any force. Only the smaller one will apply. So you can find out easily. Okay? Any doubt? No. And outside what will happen?
Both
will apply from their own center. Okay? I think straightforward. And the earlier one was more difficult than this one. Okay? But same genre.
So that mass of the third body is not required.
Yeah, but then they want the potential.
What are you talking about?
So they say there are two masses, where should the third be kept to experience of force?
We can
answer.
Extra information, like extra money given to you. Take it. What? What is your answer?
2 by root 2 plus 1. 2 by root
2 plus 1.
0.83. That's the distance, right?
0.83.
And what is the potential?
2 root 2 minus
1.4.
What is the gravitation potential energy? They are not asking potential, they are asking potential energy. That's our mass is given.
So what did you say the distance?
0.83. From 0.83 from 2 kg. You want me to solve this?
I got it. But it's like the answer is not nice.
Yeah, it's not nice looking.
But yeah, it got it.
How to define nice answer? Symmetrical? See, 2014 JEE Mains was very calculation oriented. Questions were very simple. So those guys who have this habit of using calculator, they just would not do anything. Okay? But the concepts were very, very simple. You have to be good with numbers. Good with 2014. You have to be good with numbers, okay? Being good with number is an art. It's not a, let's say, you can't look down upon someone who is good at numbers, okay? Very few people are good with numbers. Okay? Fine, so this one, four kg are kept, separation is 2 meters. Where should a third mass, no net gravitational force, so it has to be between the two masses or not?
Yeah.
It has to be between the two masses, because if it is here, both the masses will attract, net force can't be zero. Here also it will be like that, net force will get added up. But if you keep in between, one force is like this, other force will be like that. So now they can be equal and opposite. So let's say this distance is x. X should be less than half the distance or more than half the distance?
Less than half.
Less than half the distance. So it has to be closer to 2 kg. So like, if you have this basic sense, you can eliminate the options also. So 2 into 0.1 g into x square, when this become equal to g into 0.1 into 4, stop talking. Total separation is 2 meters, so 2 minus x whole square. Okay. So simplify the law, x will come out to be 0.3.
2 root 2 minus
2. 2 root 2 minus 2.
Okay, focus here. Focus, focus. Gravitation potential energy of a system. How do you find gravitation potential energy? Take two mass at a time. Gm1m2 by x, minus of that, minus of g, this divided by distance between them, then minus of g, this, that, divided by distance between these two. Okay, simply you have to add it up. Don't care about the directions at all. This one? You know, kya hua hai na, apne, we have done it for square. Triangle is simpler than that, so we'll not do this. You can just read it once. We'll move to next question. Palya? अरे बाप द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन ओनली बट देन आई थिंक दिस हैज मल्टीपल पार्ट्स ए बी सी डी फर्स्ट डू दिस
Ten
G. Ten G. Ten into capital G. ठीक है? ये तो उसका मतलब यू कैन डू यू वन प्लस द वर्क डन इज इक्वल टू यू टू प्लस के टू माइनस यू वन प्लस के वन सो चेंज इन पोटेंशियल एनर्जी राइट फाइनल पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इज जीरो माइनस इनिशियल पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इज द आंसर इनिशियल पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इज माइनस ऑफ जी एम वन एम टू बाई द रेडियस ओके एक कभी जरा नेक्स्ट वन यू हैव Do the first two parts, A and B. A and B only. It's, I think it is simple.
So is it 26 newtons.
See, field is what? Force per unit mass? So if I multiply mass with the field, I'll get the force. So 2 kg into this. So 10 newton I cap plus 24 newton J cap. That is the force. So total force is under root of x component of force plus y component of force square. Simple, right? Field is a vector. That vector multiplied by the mass will give you the force vector. And then find the magnitude of the force vector. B part, potential.
Minus 60.
Multiply by?
Yeah, integrate with r.
Potential at origin is taken 0, not at infinity. How are you approaching this? How do you approach this?
Take the work and moving it from.
Yeah. What is the relationship? What is given to his field? Do you have a relation between field and potential?
Yes.
What it has?
E is equal to
minus of dabba V by dabba R. Okay. Or you can also write down E dot dr is equal to d minus of dv. Yes or no? So when you integrate this, the right hand side will give you change in potential. Stop talking. This is V2 minus V1. Final potential minus initial potential. E dot dl, E is constant, comes out. Okay. And dr is what? Delta r. So it will become E dot delta r. Delta r is what? Final position vector E dot r2 minus r1 will give you minus of v2 minus v1. Your v1 is 0 because the first point is origin. That is what they are telling you to assume. Now find out what is v2. r1 is 0 for the first point and r2 is 12 I cap. For the second point r1 is 0 and r2 is 5 j cap. I think you can do it now. What is the answer?
Is 60 at minus?
It's plus.
Minus
plus.
60, no?
Because they're taking
negative.
Negative. It's positive. Because they're taking zero. No, but the
minus 60 is the answer.
Minus 60 at both.
Just use this formula. Don't go by anything else. V1 is 0 here. Because you've taken first point to be your origin. R1 you've taken 0. If you assume V1 to be infinity, R1 should be infinity then. Getting it? But this formula is always valid, whichever point you take as a reference. Is it clear? So other parts we can do later, as in you can do later.